is Hector Tanahara and Roy Garcia. So let's take a look at the tail of the tape. Tell us a couple of things. First off, you see the 12 years younger Tanahara, and then you see he's got an advantage of 1 inch, as Garcia. He also has a pound advantage, so nothing there. Big difference I see is Tanahara has a 3.5 inch reach advantage. He's coming off a win, and Garcia, who's an opponent type fighter, coming off a loss. So we're just about set to go with our first fight of the evening. This is the Unified Rules of Boxing, 10-point must scoring system, no standing 8 count. There's no 3 knockdown rule. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. Only the referee can stop the fight. And in case of an accidental foul, we go to the scorecard after half of the scheduled rounds. So our ring announcer is standing by, and we'll have this one underway for you momentarily. It'll be Hector Tanahara against Roy Garcia. And after that, on our free view, we've got, as I mentioned, Virgil Ortiz and Ernesto Hernandez. And then we've got Saddam Ali and Saul Carella. Tanahara, just by the fact that he's got Robert Garcia Sr. in his corner, you're going to say must be a decent fighter.
Well, 19-year-old, 6 fights, 6 wins. When you come out of Oxnard, California, just north of Los Angeles, where so many prize fighters train, and the Garcias have built that little fight culture up there.
Boxing Academy,
and if they're associated with a young fighter, you can be sure that he's regarded as a serious prospect.
So Hector Tanahara Jr. makes his way in. He turned pro in August of 2015 in Los Angeles with a knockout win over Thomas De Leon. And he's won them all ever since. He's a prospect. The book on him, he's well conditioned. He's got good speed. He's got plenty of pop in both hands. He was originally scheduled to fight Thomas Smith, but he got Garcia as a late replacement. And he may have an opponent type fighter in Garcia, but when you see a guy with a record of 3-19, you know one thing, he loves the fighter, he wouldn't be doing it, so you never know exactly what will happen there. And there you see, as Larry pointed out, Robert Garcia. And if Garcia has interest in a fight, Larry, you're right, you can be sure that this kid must be a pretty good fighter.
One of the things I've noted over the years is that fans love to fall in love with young fighters and follow their careers. And so you always wonder, when you look at a prospect, if he's the type of guy put on this show to capture fans' attention, and if they'll be saying, I saw a kid tonight that I really like, and I think he's going to be a champ someday.
And of course, you can see in this massive stadium, they have it set up around 60,000, but it's a massive place, of course, the home of the Dallas Cowboys. We're set to get this one underway, so let's get to our ring announcer, Mark Effenbein. Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our fifth bout of the evening. This is 4 rounds of action in the lightweight division, presented by Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions, sponsored by Tecate, Born Bold, O'Reilly Auto Parts, better parts, better prices every day. Hennessy, never stop, never settle. Adriana's Insurance, el seguro que necesitas al precio que quieres pagar. AT&T, mobilizing your world. And Casa Mexico Tequila, it's in the taste. Our fifth bout of the evening, 4 rounds of action in the lightweight division. Introducing first in the corner, he hails from Alice, Texas. He's wearing the red trunks with the white trim, weighing 133.5 pounds. It is Roy Garcia. Garcia. And his opponent in the red corner, he hails from San Antonio, Texas. He's got a professional record of 6 wins, no losses, 4 wins coming by way of knockout. He's wearing the blue trunks with the silver trim, weighing 132.5 pounds. It is Hector Tanahara Jr. Tanahara Jr. 4 rounds of action in the lightweight division. Your third man in the ring is Gregorio Alvarez.
Right here. All right, gentlemen, you've both been given the pre-fight rules. I want to see a clean fight. I want to see that you're protecting yourselves at all times. Most importantly, obey my commands. You got that? Touch gloves and step back.
So we're set to go here. Garcia decked out in the red and white trunks. Hector Tanahara has blue and silver. This is scheduled for 435 pounds. Garcia, as I mentioned, is a late replacement. He's had little success, 23 bouts. Turned pro in July of 2011. Lost 11 fights in a row to get things going in his career. And you wonder why he's doing it. He loves the sport.
Maybe it keeps him in good shape.
Well, he looks in good shape, Larry, even though he's a late fill-in. Round number one. Garcia trying to bring it to Tanahara here in the early going. See right away that Tanahara more offensive minded, and he's landing a few punches here and there. This is just scheduled for four rounds, but Tanahara wants to keep it going, and you don't ever want to let a veteran like Garcia, in spite of his record, get into the fight. And Tanahara Jr. is trying to do that right away as he lands the right hand. Sets up the jab and the right behind it. Good body, that half 45 degree uppercut, right hand again.
Look at a tall lightweight like this, age 19, and you think, well, someday he'll be a welterweight.
Well,
and will he be a champion?
You wonder, he's got a real lean body. Garcia's actually a little bit taller, but the way he bends over, he doesn't look tall. Nice right hand clipped him across the chin. You see the head shake of Garcia. Tanahara, round one, being patient here. Looking for his opportunity, but he's established the jab. So far, Garcia hasn't been able to do anything. He throws his jab out there, but he gets smothered by the gloves of Garcia almost every time. Slinging right hand. Tanahara not really pressing it, even though he thinks that he's got a guy that he can handle fairly well. Brazen by the left eye already of Garcia. Catching a lot of leather here in the early going. Those are hard body shots. Right on the area of the livers. Solid right hand uppercut. Larry Tanahara is landing all the leather here in round one.
Garcia is fighting in a survival mode already.
Well, he's been fighting in kind of survival mode his entire career when you consider his record 3-19 with a draw. He does have a couple of knockouts, but that goes back to the beginning of his career. His last win, by the way, for the youngster in the red trunks was in Corpus Christi in 2014 when he stopped Daniel Sanchez. So that's the end of the first round in our free view. And of course, this is the night where we've got the big fights coming up. Canelo Alvarez against Liam Smith, the WBO junior middleweight champion.
Tanahara stalking his opponent, sets up the right hand with a fake left. Didn't land this 100%, but 75% would be enough.
So 10-9, the first round goes to Tanahara. No knockdown, a little abrasion by the right eye of Roy Garcia. Colonel Bob Sheridan here with Larry Merchant. We're glad that you can be with us for this free show leading up to our big championship fight of the evening featuring Canelo Alvarez and Liam Smith. Right hand gets through again. Nice jab. The uppercut that time as he turned the hand over and snapped it up. Tanahara really sitting down on his punches too, Larry. He's pounding this guy.
I just started to wonder when he had Ortiz in the corner, is this the last round of this fight?
Well, as he picks up the pace of it, referee Alvarez having a real good look to make sure that he's not banging this kid around too much. This kid, by the way, Roy Garcia, is 31 years of age, and Tanahara, who's only a kid at 19, is fighting a man. Hard punch there. Solid right hand. Uppercut grazed the chin. Hey, you get back of the right hand. That's about the second punch Garcia's landed all night. Tanahara certainly had picked up the pace of throwing punches in this round. Right hand caught him pretty good because a little bruise on the left eye of Tanahara, so he'll know tomorrow that he was in a fight. And look at the face of Garcia. Larry, what's the point of having a kid that's a promising talent fight a guy like Garcia?
Well, part of it is just the buildup of a fighter to, in this occasion, to give him a lot of exposure. But it certainly looks like a sparring session in which a champion is fighting somebody who isn't a champion. Whether that's future tense or prince or present tense. And part of the resume, part of growing up, I'm sure his trainers will have things to say about what he did right and what he did wrong. Nothing wrong here. He got caught with a punch. A big, long, left-handed punch. So it's part of the growing, the learning, the maturing process.
And that's important, too. And Garcia really taking a lot of punishment. He's bloodied below the left eye. His blood's running out of his nose. Getting sort of beat up, and you wonder how much more referee Alvarez will let it continue. So he hasn't knocked him down.
Hard way to make a few bucks.
There is. As long as you and I have been in this business, these young kids, you see them coming along like this, it still amazes me what a rough racket this is. Round two is in the books, another Tanahara round.
Tweet us using hashtag Snapchat filter and look yourself to selfie at Snapchat filter on team.com. Hashtag Mel Smith. Let us know what central seat and row you are sitting in. And it's just that easy to come up on an autograph.
So here we have that surprise right-handed counterpunch from Garcia that landed solidly but didn't seem to bother the younger fighter.
Here we go, round number three at the beautiful AT&T Colossal Stadium, as I call it, in Arlington, Texas. Hector Tanahara Jr. in the blue and white, and Roy Garcia, as you see, in the red and white. This is round three. It's interesting to note that since 2014, 8 straight losses for Garcia, but 7 of them went the distance. Pretty sturdy guy, and he's well able to take a lot of punishment because that's about all he's been doing, with the exception of that replay that we had for you that saw Garcia landing a wild right hand. Uppercuts. It's really one thing I like about the youngster Tanahara, remembering he's only 19, he really knows how to throw a jab. He drives off the back foot, Larry, and he snaps it out there. He throws it as a punch.
When you have a match and one of the fighters is just determined to survive, usually a good professional can survive if that's his goal. And certainly that looks like Garcia's goal.
Yeah, good body shot, digging body shot, and that elbow. Those are the kind of body shots that both Alvarez and Liam Smith throw. And that main event tonight, a little bit later on.
Stop! Step back! Let's go fight.
Garcia is certainly tough. Anybody that's willing to get into the ring is tough, in my opinion. But just no success with this Tanahara, who's able to block his punches, able to get his jab through. He usually throws a right hand right behind it, just like that. Comes with that uppercut. So his uppercut, his jab is good. And Garcia shakes his head no. Right back with the left hook to Tanahara. Closing seconds now of round number three. More of the same. Tanahara Jr. just outboxing Roy Garcia. Nobody down, nobody shaken so far, but Tanahara winning every round.
Los cinturones aquí se hacen a un lado. Hay que pelear por honor y por gloria nada más.
I've got a style like Yelena Jr. There's no messing about.
When the international show starts, you can watch live on pay-per-view Canelo Alvarez and Liam Smith, and you can order it online at goldenboypbv.com. So remember that. You can hear Larry and I in the pay-per-view online.
Second job.
And we'll be calling the four fights that are on the main card.
Last round.
And
last round.
We're entertaining you, courtesy right of Oscar De La Hoya. Right and Step Eric here. Gomez Step and the entire staff at Golden Boy with these early fights. So we get you in the fight mood for tonight. I'll miss Larry and I calling the big fights. GoldenBoyPayPerView.com. This is round four. Hector Tanahara Jr. against Roy Garcia. Roy hasn't had much success at all throughout the course of this fight. As I mentioned, he's gone the distance in seven of his last eight fights, but hasn't had any wins. But, you know, I asked you earlier, Larry, why they would put Tanahara in with this. And, of course, we know he wants to get the work, but a guy that's sturdy that can go the full four rounds is good work for Tanahara, too.
And maybe Garcia someday will be able to tell his grandchildren that he went the distance with the great Hector Tanahara.
Well, we hope that works out for Tanahara. But so far, Tanahara hasn't been able to drop him. He does have four knockouts and six wins. This product of San Antonio. Turned pro in 2015 last year in Los Angeles. With a knockout win in his debut over Thomas De Leon. As I told you, he's a real prospect. I mean, it's easy to see the class, but I mean, he is a boy fighting a man in 19 years old against a 31-year-old guy who's been in the ring professionally. A lot of times, not a lot of success. As sturdy as he is and as tough as Roy Garcia is, I give him a lot of credit for hanging in there because he's been taking a lot of shots. That left hand can come from a hook, it can come from a straight jab. That time, Tanahara was able to block the wild left hand of Garcia. Garcia again in red, Tanahara in the black.
Suddenly, Garcia is the aggressor.
Trying to be, to show you his heart and why he lasts so long in so many fights. He may be an opponent type fighter, but he's not an opponent that comes just to, you know, take a shot and lay down. He's here to fight. Not highly skilled, but he's highly tough. I like like all the tools I see of Tanahara, and I especially like at this stage in his career how patient he is when he knows he's got this guy totally under control.
The only question will be, does he have the kind of striking ability, punching power, to move up through the ranks?
And that's a question we ask of all young fighters, but he does have the 4 knockouts and his, you know...
7 fights now,
yeah,
Colonel.
Yeah, 7 fights, right. From Venezuela, one of the top fighters in the lightweight division as the bell ends. Anthony Carolla of the UK, another good one, and Terry Flanagan. So these are the types of guys that eventually Tanahara will have to face. I think he pitched the shutout here, 40-36, I've got it. We'll wait and see how the judges have it.
I'm holding my breath, Colonel.
The last round when he did a little pivot over, he landed up because the guy was like, son, you didn't see it.
Well, you said it from the get-go, Larry, when Robert Garcia has a fighter, you know he's not wasting his time with somebody that can't fight, and he will develop this youngster. And Hector Tanahara is appears to be one of the good young fighters in that Robert Garcia stable.
Tanahara just going through his paces, doesn't seem over eager to try to score the knockout. One of the things a young fighter has to learn is, let the knockout come. And some nights it doesn't.
So again, I scored at 40-36. We'll wait for our ring announcer to gather up the score sheets. And when we do, Mark Effenbein will have the scores for us, and we'll have this underway. Next is Virgil Ortiz and Ernesto Hernandez, and a scheduled super lightweight battle in the junior lightweight division. Okay, here's our ring announcer. Mark, go ahead, take it away. Mark Effenbein.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. All 3 judges score the bout 40-36. Your winner by unanimous decision, Hector Tanahara Jr. Tanahara Jr.
So Tanahara Jr., as we expected, got the unanimous decision, and it was totally unanimous. He won every round. So we look forward to see him again real soon. Hector Tanahara Jr., winner by unanimous decision.